Conor McGregor was just arrested in Miami Beach, and according to police, it was because he smashed a fan's phone and then stole it. Does anyone else think Conor McGregor should go to anger management? Because I'm noticing like a pattern of behavior here. This pattern of behavior can only get worse if Conor McGregor doesn't do something to control his temper. Welcome back to Inform Overload, the news channel for people who find CNN boring. Hit that subscribe for daily news updates that are actually interesting, and follow the IO team on Instagram. By the way, hey, what's up? I'm Charlotte, I'm the main host on this channel. Actually, the first video I ever did on IO was a story about Conor McGregor and Nate Diaz. Hey guys, holy crap, what a fight at UFC 196 over the weekend between Conor McGregor and Diaz. Diaz beat McGregor in less than 2 rounds and only had 11 days to prepare for the fight. That is crazy. My times have changed. This time, Conor isn't in the news because of one of his fights. He's in the news once again for losing his temper. Conor McGregor is known for being the bad boy of MMA. They don't call him the notorious MMA for nothing. In addition to being a former UFC 2 division champion, McGregor is constantly in trouble with the law. Most recently, in Miami. Outside the Fontainebleau Miami Beach Hotel, while McGregor was walking out of the resort at around 5 AM, a fan tried taking a picture of him on his phone. That's when McGregor smashed the phone out of the fan's hand and stomped on it several times. Meh! Meh! But McGregor didn't just stop there. Oh no, he didn't. He picked up the phone off the ground, valued at $1,000, and walked away with it. Why? This resulted in a slew of charges, felony strong-armed robbery, as well as misdemeanor criminal mischief. It's like, sure, maybe Conor didn't want to have his photo taken, but I mean, dude, you're famous. You should somewhat expect people taking your photo while you're out in public. And then you stomped on the phone and walked away with it? What was the point of that? It's not like Conor can't afford his own phone, but because he took the phone from the fan, he was charged with robbery. And where was his security during all of this? According to the Miami Herald, the incident was caught on surveillance camera. Conor wasn't arrested at the scene, but police tracked him and found him at a home in Miami Beach. He was then booked into the Turner Guilford Knight Correctional Center in Miami. As of 10:30 AM on Monday, he was no longer at the facility. His bond was valued at $12,500, and he's expected to be arraigned in 21 days. I'm noticing a pattern of behavior here with McGregor. I mean, he literally just finished his community service at churches to clear his previous record, and now he did this? Back in April, he infamously attacked a bus with UFC lightweight champion Khabib Nurmagomedov and other fighters inside. Several people were hurt after McGregor threw a dolly through the window of the bus. And yeah. And then he was arrested. Nurmagomedov and McGregor have a history. In October, Nurmagomedov submitted McGregor in the 4th round of a fight, which prevented him from getting his title back. Both fighters were fined and suspended because of a post-fight fight. McGregor's suspension is over in April, and when that happens, he'll be eligible to fight again, but I mean, he won't be able to fight again if he keeps getting in trouble with the law. Repeated violations of the law and a pattern of behavior are judged more severely in court. Sure, he smashed a phone and took it, which isn't a big deal, I guess, but the fact that he had a previous record for another incident where he lost his temper could mean a harsher punishment for McGregor. Conor McGregor doesn't seem too bothered about this, though. After being released from custody, he shared this post on Instagram early Tuesday morning with the caption, "Patience in this world is a virtue I continue to work on. I love my fans dearly. Thank you all." Some fans were saying in the comment section of this photo that they love Conor, but when he keeps acting out like this, it makes it harder to cheer for him. Do you agree? Do you not? Let me know down there in the comments. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some comment features. Comment dance. Just Chill for Life said, "I laughed so hard my drink came out of my nose." Ew. Someone on the internet said, "Sorry, but the camera angles makes this way more funny than it should be for some reason." I agree. Definitely add something. Christopher said, "What's your zodiac, potato queen? I'm a Leo." Of course you are. I'm a proud Virgo. Hey, what's up? Fallen X said, "You're hilarious." Thanks. Antoine Brown said, "I see your eyes reading." Yes, Antoine, there's a teleprompter right there. I'm reading it. This is the end screen. It means the video is over. Thanks so much for watching. But if you want to keep watching, there's a playlist right over here that you should definitely click on. Obviously, if you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so I can see you in a future IO video.